Vice President Mike Pence will continue a rigorous campaign schedule after two of his top aides, including one he has been in close contact with, tested positive for coronavirus on Saturday, prompting speculation of a second White House outbreak. Short's test comes after a cluster of coronavirus infections swept the White House earlier this month, an outbreak that included dozens of White House staffers, Republican politicians and other Trump allies including President Trump, First Lady Melania Trump and Trump's son Barron. Trump was briefly hospitalized at Walter Reed Medical Center and treated with antibodies but has since recovered. Does the WH have another outbreak? Tweeted MSNBC anchor Chris Hayes. Mark Short did not travel with VP to Florida today. In addition, staffers deemed close contacts with the CUS were pulled from the trip before departure as well, either leaving the plane or not arriving to travel, reported Pence Pool reporter Megan Pratz. White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows worked to keep the news of Short's infection a secret, New York Times White House correspondent Maggie Haberman reported based on two anonymous sources. If you needed more evidence of the Trump administration's failure to contain COVID-19, there's now a coronavirus outbreak in the VP's Coronavirus Task Force office, tweeted former Obama official and Democratic presidential candidate Julian Castro. The sign-up website for Pence's North Carolina rally on Sunday features the usual waiver for attendees. By registering for this event, you understand and expressly acknowledge that an inherent risk of exposure to COVID-19 exists in any public place where people are present, 51%. That's the share of voters in a Morning Consult Politico poll released earlier this month who gave Pence, who heads up the White House Coronavirus Task Force, a rating of fair or poor on his handling of the virus. Only 40%, by contrast, gave him a rating of good or positive. 50% of voters in that poll said Democratic candidate would do a better job than Trump at containing the virus, while only 35% said Trump would do better. Full coverage and live updates on the coronavirus.